Westdale 279. Who is that, please? A call from Greece? At 5:15 in the morning? Yes, that's right. It's Mrs. Jackson speaking. Yes, Susan Jackson, that's my daughter. It's all right. It's all right. I'll take the call. Oh, Susan. Hello. Hello, I'm sorry. Oh, dear, it's a very bad line. I can't hear you properly. Could you speak up, please? Who is that? Yes? Yes, that's right. It's Mrs. Jackson speaking. Susan Jackson, that's she's my daughter, yes. Have I... News? What, do you mean news about Susan? No, I have... What? She's been what? Well, where? Well, when? When did it happen?
Thank you, Maxwell. I can't say I'm sorry to be back. 12 days in Morocco is enough for anybody. I see Mr. Maul is here.
Yes, sir. He arrived last night. I've put him in the room next to yours. He's on the telephone at the moment.
Yes, all right, fine.
Sir, your letters are on the desk and some messages too.
Yes, all right. I'll look at them later, Maxwell. So, you know, I could do with a cup of coffee, and I expect Mr. Morley could too.
Very good, sir. Oh, sir, Mrs. Jackson phoned very early this morning.
Mrs. Jackson? What does she want, do you know?
Well... Mr. Morley took the call, sir. I thought it best.
Did you? It's all right, Maxwell. I'll get the coffee, would you, and then tell Mr. Morley I'm here.
Yes, sir.
Ah, hello, Alistair. How nice of you to come. You got my last cable, did you?
Yes, I got it, James.
Well, the Moroccan end is tied up. Now all we've got to do is to swing Steinberger our way. Yeah, I've got to see him in 2 days in New York, so I thought we'd better go over the details together, don't you think?
Oh, fine.
Do you mind if we leave it till after lunch?
James, hasn't Maxwell told
you what?
Mrs. Jackson rang.
Oh, yes, he did say you took the call. Was it important?
Susan has been arrested.
Arrested?
Just within the Greek frontier. She's being held on the charge of subversive activities against the state.
Well, that's ridiculous for a start.
It seems she was travelling with 3 students. The authorities are saying they were trying to smuggle inflammatory leaflets into the country.
Who told you this?
Mrs. Jackson had a call direct from Greece. I tried to ring you at the airport.
Well, why didn't you?
It's a nasty situation, James. It might get worse, because Mrs. Jackson's been told they may have to face a military tribunal. And that's really not very funny.
Well, we'd better get on to the Foreign Office right away.
I've done that, and I spoke to Dickie Brown.
What did he say?
Our embassy in Athens hasn't been notified of the arrest of any British subjects during the last few weeks.
Now tell me about this telephone call from Greece. Was it a man or a woman?
It was a man.
Did you give his name?
No. I asked him, but he just said it was a friend. Somebody who felt I ought to know what had happened.
Was he Greek?
Well, I suppose so. He had a foreign accent. It was a terrible line.
All right, tell me exactly what he said.
Well, he just said that Susan had been arrested by the Greek soldiers in a place called Athmos. Her and the 3 other people who were with her.
And nobody's been in touch with you to confirm this story. I mean, nobody from the Greek embassy or from Whitehall.
No. No, your friend, Mr.
Morley?
Mr. Morley said he was going to get in touch with the Foreign Office.
Yes, he has. They don't know anything about it, I'm afraid.
Yes, but I mean, you read about these things, don't you? People do get arrested and held for days, weeks even, and nobody hears anything about it. You read about it, but you never think it's going to happen to your own child.
Tell me about these 3 people she was arrested with.
Well, I don't know anything. I mean, well, they were students.
Did you give
British
their names?
Students, no.
There wasn't anything in what he said, or, I mean, the way he spoke that could conceivably have meant it was a practical joke, was it?
Oh, no, Mr. No, who'd ever do a thing like that?
Well, there are people.
Oh, no. Oh, well, I'm quite sure it certainly was genuine. I mean, well, he seemed sort of frightened, you know, as if he didn't want to be overheard. And anyway, no, he knew so much about Susan. He described her to me, some of the things she was wearing, things I'd bought for her before she went away. Anyway, the Westdale Exchange said it was a telephone call from Greece. That's a pretty expensive practical joke. Besides, it all fits in with the postcard she sent me, the one I got from Belgrade. You can read it.
Things are looking up. I found myself three wonderful students. They're going into Greece to spread the gospel, and I'm going with them, I'm sure. Yeah, well, that fits, doesn't it?
What does she mean, spread the gospel?
Well, the leaflet? You mean you think she knew they were going to smuggle them in?
It's possible,
no,
isn't it?
She's a reporter. She'd know the risks. She's going out there to write a story, not to make
one. Oh, I know. She's practical and she's level-headed, but she's a great one for causes. She's, what's that word they're always using on television, that she's committed.
Well, she may be committed, but she's not a fool. If what you're saying is true, that means she not only knew they had the leaflets, but she was going along to help distribute them. Well, that means that she's guilty.
I know. Ever since I got the telephone call, I've been praying it didn't happen that way. Since 6 o'clock this morning, I've vacuumed and dusted every room in the house, and it's the second time I've cleaned the silver.
Now, Mrs. Jackson, you know her better than that.
Do I? Oh, she's my daughter, but she's a grown woman. Things she gets excited about, the things in the world that she wants to see changed. I don't know what she's talking about half the time. Knowing her as you do, can you honestly say that she couldn't have been carrying those leaflets?
No. Right, that's the Moroccan contract. Now, there are one or two changes in the original draft, so you better go over it carefully tonight. Those are the development schedules. They've been checked and agreed by the consulting engineers, and those are the final costings. I think that's the lot. Now, here's your air ticket. It's in my name, but I've rung the airport, and they know you're going in my place. I've also cabled Steinberger, so he'll be expecting you.
Fine. There are several things I'd like to talk over with you. We can do that in the car.
Sorry to do this to you, Alistair. I know he put you in a hell of a spot.
What else could you do? Any hope I can get with the Americans?
Well, I'll cable you from New York, and then you'll know where to get in touch with me.
You do realize, don't you, that I may not be able to pull this off. Steinberger's going to need a lot of convincing.
Well, you must just do the best you can, mustn't you?
If I come back empty-handed, you stand to lose a lot of money.
Yes. Yes, I know I do.
I've packed a suitcase for you, sir.
All right, Maxwell, would you put it in Mr. Morley's car? Where'd you stop?
Very good, sir. Sir, Mrs. Maxwell and I would like to say how very upset we were to hear about Miss Jackson. We'd be grateful if you'd tell her when you see her that we're thinking of her.
Yes, I will, and I think she'll appreciate that. Thank you. All right, you ready, Alistair?
What flight are you booked on?
Oh, I'm not waiting for a scheduled flight.
Thank you.
Mr. Hadley, you really shouldn't have come here to Salonika, you know.
Really?
Well, you can't do a bit of good. You see, in a case like this, everything must be done through official channels.
And what are official channels doing about the arrest of these people?
Nothing. No. You know, but there's nothing they can do, you see, until they're notified of the arrests by their appropriate government department.
Meanwhile, four British subjects are being held in a Greek jail.
Yes, yes, I dare say, but you see, we haven't heard about it here, at least not from them.
No, but you have made inquiries.
Oh, naturally. As soon as I got the cable from our ambassador in Athens, I jumped in the car and drove straight to Athens. Dreadful place, you know. Never seen so many flies anywhere.
Yes. And what did you find out?
Nothing. No. Well, Athens is a military district, you realize. And, of course, well, the whole country is under the army these days. Anyway, I sent in my card to the local commander, a man called Stylianos. Mm. Do you know he wouldn't even see me, old man? I mean, that sort of thing would never have happened in the old days, I can tell you. What, a British consul turned away without so much as an interview? Oh, times have changed.
But you persisted?
Naturally. I told the orderly to go back and inform Major Stylianos that I'd come to investigate rumours that he'd arrested four British subjects. Still wouldn't see me. Too busy.
But he did confirm that he was holding these people.
Well, he merely sent out a message saying that if there had been any arrests in his district, then we'd be notified about it in due course through the,
the official channel.
Quite. So, you see, there was nothing I could do but leave it at that. You see, diplomatically speaking, well, things are very tricky here, Mr. Hadley. I sometimes think even London doesn't realize just how tricky it is. The military's got the whole country sewn up tight. So, of course, a man like Stylianos, well, he's pretty much a law unto himself, so long as he keeps his district in line. It's not even any good complaining to Athens. Of course, I mean, there was a time when you'd simply to wave the Union Jack and it acted like a magician's wand. I mean, doors open, people jumped, end of problem. Yes, I think I'd have enjoyed the consular service then. But those days gone, I'm afraid.
So what happens now?
Well, we should keep on trying, of course. But you do see that until we're notified, our hands are tied.
Yes. Yes, I do see your problem. Tell me, where exactly is Athmos?
It's here. It's a little place on the Yugoslav frontier. It's little more than a large village, really. I say, Hadley, Mrs. Pembry and I would be terribly pleased if you'd come and have dinner with us tonight. You really ought to see something of Salonika before you leave. There's some very fine Byzantine churches, you know. And, of course, Ataturk was born here.
Yes. Yes, we had a little trouble with him, didn't we, once upon a time?
What? Oh, yes, of course, the Dardanelles, yes. How true. Yeah, well, what about dinner tonight?
Yes, it's very kind of you, but I think I'd just better have a go at Stylianos myself.
Oh, I say, my dear chap, you can't do that. You might get into the most frightful trouble. Besides, as I've already told you, he wouldn't even see me, and I do represent the British government.
Well, perhaps it's time for a little private enterprise, don't you think?
Carlos
Africami. Kesarete Angelica.
Oh, a little.
Good. Well, I'd like a room.
So how long you stay?
Oh, two or three days, maybe more.
Well, why not? Nice place for holiday.
Do you think you can get my case in? It's in the car and put it up in the room because I've got to go out.
Yes.
And can you tell me where the military headquarters are?
The military?
Yes.
Soldiers. You mean the soldiers?
Yeah, that's right.
Yes. It's down the street, is a big place with flags.
All
right. Mr. Hadley, how do you do? I'm Major Savas Stylianos. You had a long journey from Saloniki. I hope it was not too tiring.
You've been expecting me?
From the moment you first arrived in Greece, when was that? Yesterday morning, was it not? Do sit down.
You're very well informed.
It is necessary to have good communications.
Yeah, I had no idea my arrival would create such interest.
Come, Mr. Hadley, you are too modest. You're a man of importance and influence. You're also a close personal friend of Miss Jackson. So it is only natural that I should assume that sooner or later you would come to Athmos. Cigarette?
No, thank you, sir. It is true, then, that you have arrested this girl.
I regret to say yes, and the charge is a serious one, subversive activities against the state.
Then why hasn't the British Embassy in Athens been informed?
There will be. There are a few formalities to be observed. Everything must go through proper channels, you understand.
And the people she was traveling with?
They have also been detained.
On what evidence?
I'm not sure I can discuss it with you.
But you have got evidence.
Naturally. We act strictly within the law in this country. Democracy is a Greek word, Mr. Hadley.
Yes. So is tyranny, Major.
We are not here to argue the finer points of semantics, are we? Your concern is the welfare of Miss Jackson.
Yes, would you please tell me who these people she was arrested with are?
John Scully, Derek Thorne, Mary Fleming. All three are students, as one might expect. You have trouble with students from time to time, I believe.
Yes, we don't arrest them for carrying leaflets, Major.
Things are quite different in Greece. We are going through a very difficult time. We cannot tolerate open incitement to rebellion.
Now, how on earth do you know that that's what they had in mind?
I didn't. Not until I sent a patrol out to check. We often get results that way.
Have they distributed any of these leaflets?
No, at least I'm not aware of it, if they did.
Well, surely.
I think the court will find possession sufficient evidence for a conviction.
So there is going to be a trial?
Yes, and if Miss Jackson is found guilty, the imprisonment is likely to be not less than 5 years. There has been too much of this kind of thing going on lately. We have been very lenient with foreigners, but now the government's patience is exhausted. An example must be made by the court to deter others.
Does she know about this?
Yes, I told her myself.
How did she take it?
Not very well, but then you would hardly expect her to...
May I see her?
No. Officially, that is. Unofficially, because you have come from so far and because you're a close friend of hers.
Yes.
Traste mesa, paracalo. Please go with this man.
Was to hitchhike straight down to Athens if we could, and then onto the islands. But when we got to the frontier here, Mary Fleming wasn't feeling too well. Yeah. Wasn't anything serious, not a touch of the sun, but we decided to camp. The local farmer let us put up our tents in his olive grove.
Did you go to town much?
A couple of times. Most of the things we needed, like milk and cheese, we bought from the farmer.
Did you only visit it? Not even the farmer?
No, not even him. I used to go to his house and we'd talk, but he seemed content to leave us alone.
Yeah, go on.
On Sunday, we decided we'd pack up and leave for Athens the next day.
But you didn't get the chance.
No. Just finishing breakfast when Stylianus's men dropped in. They asked to see our passports. We showed them to them, and they made us stand against some trees while they searched the tents.
Yeah, what happened next?
I brought out our rucksacks and emptied them on the ground in front of us.
And there were the leaflets?
Yes, 4 packets of them, 1 in each rucksack.
And you'd never seen them before?
Never, I swear
it. All right. Have you seen the others? Since you've been arrested, I mean.
No. I mean, kept separated from them for some reason.
Thank you.
I don't suppose you've got a cigarette, have you? I was right out when they pinched us, haven't I?
Yes.
A couple of days.
So here, keep the pack.
Thanks. The others don't smoke, but it's been murder for me. Sorry about Derek. He was awake all night having bad dreams.
Will they let us have other visitors, do you think? I mean, like parents, if they come over.
I don't know. Let's just hope it won't be necessary.
They're not going to let us go. Not just like that.
Now, why not, if you're innocent?
And who's going to prove that?
Well, more important, of course, are you?
You had to ask that, I suppose.
Yes, yes, I did.
You've spoken to Sue. What does she say?
She says you are.
We'd never seen those leaflets before.
Now, you've got to tell me the truth about...
We'd take an oath on it.
Look, didn't Sue tell you we're pacifists? If we come into Greece with any intention of stirring up trouble, which we didn't, it would have been the non-violent kind.
Why are they keeping Sue separated from...
Why was Sue's mother the only one to get a phone call?
Well, she talked to a lot of people in the town. Maybe someone saw her in a fix and wanted to help her.
Yes, perhaps.
Why should anyone want to arrest us?
Because we're over 18 and under 23. We fit perfectly.
Yes, but Sue's not a student. She's a journalist.
You asked us if we were carrying those leaflets. But not if we thought Susan was. She could have been, you know, and used us to get them across the frontier.
But of course, Mr. Hadley. I will see to it that Miss Jackson's makeup and toilet things are returned to her immediately. I had no idea she was without them. Little things like that are very important to women.
You know they swear they've never seen those leaflets before, don't you?
Naturally. And I have included their denial in my report.
May I see them?
Do you read Greek?
Only a little, I'm afraid.
A copy of this report in English, together with the other relevant documents, will be forwarded to the British Embassy before the trial.
You know what I think, don't you? I think somebody planted those leaflets on them.
For what possible reason?
To create an incident.
And who would be interested in creating such an incident?
You, perhaps, Major.
Me? Why should I do something which can only embarrass my government? All right, we need foreign tourists in Greece.
What about the resistance?
No, I don't see how arresting four young Britons could help them.
I do. By discrediting the Greek government in the foreign press.
As far as I am concerned, Miss Jackson and the others attempted to smuggle those leaflets into my country and they were caught. There the matter ends until they are tried and sentenced.
All right, all right. I take it you don't mind my staying in Athmos just for a day or two.
None whatever. As I told you before, Mr. Hadley, this is a free country.
Yeah, for the Greeks, or for the tourists as well?
For all those who observe our laws.
Ah, nice room. Lots of you.
Yeah, look, I want to make a telephone call to England.
England is possible.
Yes, yes, look, I'll write it down for you. It's Westdale, in New Yorkshire, 279.
Westdale, Yorkshire, 279. I got it.
Now, would you get it for me, please, and then I'll take it in my room.
Oh, sorry. Nice room. Lots of you. No telephone. You wait. I call you.
Yes, all right. Fine.
I call you.
Mr. Hadley?
Yes?
My name is Philondrakis. Milos Philondrakis. I would speak with you, please.
Well, all right. What can I do for
you? No, no, not here. Please. We sit down. Mr. Hadley, you are the friend of the young English girl, Miss Susan Jackson. She is in prison.
Yes.
You have seen her? She is all right. They have not hurt her.
No, they haven't hurt her. Why do you ask?
I am Milos Philandrakis. Did she not tell you about me? For 3 days she camped on my olive grove with her friend. I like her. Many times she come over to my house and we talk. She tells me about her life in England, about her mother, about her friend, Mr. James Hadley, the big landowner, bigger even than Philandrakis.
Were you there when she was arrested?
No, but I hear about it. There was nothing I could do, Mr. Hadley. One dare not interfere with the military. So I think to myself, she's a nice girl, she's my friend. I must help her. And so I telephone to her mother in England and tell her what has happened.
Oh, it was you who made that telephone
call?
Yes,
it was a very dangerous thing for me to do. Even now, I don't know if it is known to the authorities. You see, Mr. Hadley, nowadays in my country, people disappear forever. One day they are there, next day they are gone. No one sees them again.
Well, I happen to think that she's innocent of those charges.
Yes, I have no doubt about it. Such a lovely girl. For so many hours, we talk.
Well, I'm going to have a damn good try at proving it. Would you help me?
No. I cannot be involved. It is dangerous for me to even to be seen with you. You must excuse me. I have a wife and children.
Yep.
Already I have done too much.
Sir? Telephone. She's in England.
Right, thank you. Yes, thank you. No. Yeah, Farisa. Hello, Mrs. Jackson. This is James Hadley. I'm telephoning you from Greece. Yes, I have, but please, would you listen very carefully? There's something I must know. And a Greek bearing gifts. Fruit, chocolate, cigarettes. They smell pretty foul, but they might taste... Well, you're different. What's happened?
When I was in the exercise yard, a woman who works in the prison kitchen has managed to speak to me without the guard seeing.
Who was she, you know?
Some woman from the village. She said, if the Englishman goes to the cafe tonight, there'll be people there who can help you and your friends.
Is that all?
Well, it means there are people here in Athens who are on our side.
There's no guarantee of that.
I know it might not come to anything. But it's you arriving and now this.
What's the name of this cafe, do you know?
You want a drink, Mac?
Hey, you see? Special for you, I speak English. Hey, you like it? You from London, eh?
Well, near enough, a little further north, actually. Do you know London?
Me? I have never been out of Greece. America, that's the place I want to go. Do you know they got real gangsters there? Just like the Humphrey Bogart and Jimmy Cagney. Hey, you got gangsters in London?
Well, a few, yes, but they're not so colorful.
I really go for gangsters. You know that movie Scarface?
Yeah.
I see it 8 times. Oh, that Paul Muni's a real gangster. Check him up, you dirty double crosser. He's a Greek, you know.
I thought he was Italian.
Yeah, maybe that's what the Italians say. They steal anything. Well, Englishman, what do you have? Beer, ouzo, or a very expensive scotch?
Make it a scotch, man.
Okay, bud. Whiskey. I would take it outside if I were you. It's more private.
That's all right. I'm quite happy here.
Maybe you don't understand. You've got company.
Are unimportant.
I thought we were meant to be friends.
We are. This is not a game we are playing. The dangers are very real for all of us.
All right, then who do you represent?
Those who are concerned with bringing freedom back to Greece.
And how can you help my friend?
You realize the situation she is in?
Yes, I think so.
The minimum penalty for her crime is 5 years in prison. But the maximum penalty, Mr. Hadley, is deaf.
And world opinion.
World opinion. In any case, you don't want your friend to serve a prison sentence. Women suffer very much in Greek prisons. I know. I have seen.
All right, how can you prevent it?
The garrison in Athens is not large. We can get Miss Jackson out of prison and across the Yugoslav frontier in 2 hours.
Now, why are you doing this? Simply out of a sense of justice?
Hardly. The fate of Miss Jackson is no concern to us. But we do you a service, and in return, we expect something from you.
What?
The resistance needs weapons. So we come to a simpler arrangement. We will free Miss Jackson, and you will give us arms.
Arms? But I haven't got any arms. I've no access to them.
We know that. You just give us a bank draft on one of your business accounts in Geneva.
How much?
£10,000.
That's a great deal of money.
You're a rich man. We have checked. It's not much to pay for the release of your friend.
And if I don't agree?
Then at best, you condemn your friend to 5 years in prison. An experience, I assure you, that will leave its mark on her for the rest of her life. There's no alternative, Mr. Hadley. I must have your answer now.
All right. Then the answer's no. You're using Miss Jackson to involve me in the internal politics of her country when you're not getting guns from me.
In that case, you're wasting our time.
That's right.
But if you should change your mind, Mr. Hadley...
I shan't change my mind.
You will, Mr. Hadley, you will, because you see, the day after tomorrow, Miss Jackson and the others are to be transferred on a camp on one of the islands. And you know what they do to people on those islands.
Why can't I see Miss Jackson today?
Sit down, Mr. Hadley. I have already stretched the regulations by allowing you to see her at all. But now I have received strict instructions from Athens. She's to see no one until after she's been transferred.
So it's true. They are going to be moved.
You have heard?
A rumor, yes.
This town is full of rumors, but yes, this one is true. Within 48 hours, all the prisoners in my garrison are going to be moved to the camp on the island of Ithacus.
And when is the trial going to be?
I don't know. That is a decision for the prosecutor's office.
All right. Would you give her a message from me? Would you tell her I'll get her a lawyer from England?
Is that all?
For the moment, yes.
Hiya, Joe. You want a whiskey?
Make it a coffee.
Hey, how do you like Atmos? Oh, no, don't tell me. I tell you. It's dead, huh? You know, me, I have made up my mind. For 1 year, I save all my money, then I sell this place, and I go and live in Chicago.
Join the mafia, eh?
Hey, do they take Greeks?
You're looking for your friends.
Why, can you get in touch with them?
Sure. You know, Andreas, the stupid one who can't speak English. She's my wife's cousin.
And the other one?
Grigori.
Yeah.
He manages the olive presses for Milos Philondrakis.
Is he?
Yeah. Nearly everyone in Athens works for Philondrakis.
Look, if I were to write a note, do you think you could get it delivered?
Come on in.
Mr. Hadley, I told you that I could not be involved, but your note said it was important.
Yes, it is. It's very important. I'm very grateful to you for coming. Please sit down.
No, no, I cannot wait. I told you that it was dangerous for me to be seen with you.
Really? Why is that?
Mr. Hadley, you do not seem to understand. Miss Jackson and her friends, they camp on my land. Before the military took over, I was the mayor here. They know that I do not agree with them. Already they look upon me as unreliable. So if I were to help you, or even be seen with you, they might think perhaps that I knew that your friends had those leaflets.
But you did know, didn't you?
No, I did not.
Oh, yes, you did. Because you planted those leaflets in their rucksacks.
Mr. Hadley, please, to say such a thing, even as a joke, it could make bad trouble.
I'm not joking. You're a member of the resistance.
No, I know nothing about politics. I want only to run my business and stay out of trouble.
Well, if you wanted to stay out of trouble, you should never have put those leaflets in the rucksacks, my friend.
Why should I want to see those four young persons in prison?
We'll get to that.
Then it was I, Philandrakis, who made that telephone call to England.
Yes, you did.
Which shows that I could not have done what you suggest. Mr. Hadley, you are desperate. You will say and do anything to help Miss Jackson. Mm-hmm. You'll excuse me. I am leaving.
Oh, no, you're not. I'm afraid it's too late. You're right, Philandrakis. I will. I'll do anything to get those kids out of jail. But I'm not going to do it the way you suggest.
My way?
Yes. The way that was put to me last night by your man, Grigori.
You're mad. I know nothing of this. I will not listen to you no more.
See what I mean? When I say it's too late.
Why is this man here?
He's part of a deal, Major, that you and I are just about to complete.
Deal? What deal?
A deal whereby you release Susan Jackson and her friends, and I hand over to you a member of the resistance. Milos Philandrakis, humanitarian and businessman. I'll also give you the name of two of his associates.
Mr. Hadley is ill, Major. The sun, it is too much for him.
Perhaps.
Do we do a deal?
We might. Have you any evidence against this man?
No, it's just a theory, but it'll hold up.
But, Major, you're not going to listen to him.
Tell me your theory, Mr. Hadley.
All right, it goes like this. Susan Jackson and her friends, they camp in the olive grove belonging to a landowner. She goes up to the house, she talks to this landowner, she tells him all about herself, that she's a journalist, that she comes from Westdale, and most important of all, of course, that she's the friend of a wealthy and influential Englishman. Am I right so far, Philandrakis? Shall I go on?
Please.
Resistance in Athmos needs money for guns. Now, the landowner sees in this English girl a chance of getting it. They'll plant leaflets in her rucksack and they'll see that she's arrested. They'll telephone her mother in England and hey presto, out'll fly a gullible knight in shining armour with a bank balance in Geneva. For £10,000, they were going to attack your headquarters and free the prisoners. This was put to me by a man called Grigori last night, and he works for Philandrakis.
Well, this proves Grigori's guilt, but it does not mean that Philandrakis is implicated. And frankly, Mr. Hadley, your theory does not hold water. It's pure supposition.
When he made that telephone call to England, he's admitted that.
Yes, but that does not make him a dangerous subversive. It would have been more to the point if he had telephoned me.
Why?
How else could he have guaranteed the arrest of four young Britons? We received no such information.
But they were arrested.
Mr. Hadley, you're clutching at straws. Philandrakis could not have known what was going to happen.
Couldn't he?
No.
All right, then tell me this. The arrests, according to your report, were made at 8:30 in the morning, correct?
I told you so.
Then how did he make that phone call at 6:15?
How do you know?
Because I rang Mrs. Jackson and I checked. Now, don't you find that curious? Now, I don't know why Philandrakis was able to make that phone call 2 hours before the event, but I'll have a bloody good guess. Because you told him.
He is right. You are ill, Mr. Hadley.
For the commander of a remote military district, you knew a hell of a lot about me, didn't you? The British consul couldn't get in to see you, but I had no difficulty at all, and you never once asked me how I knew that Susan Jackson had been arrested. Nobody else knew. The embassy didn't know.
And do you know why? Because you knew about that telephone call.
It is an interesting theory, Mr. Hadley, but only that.
Well, it's enough for an inquiry, prompted by the British ambassador.
Of course, such an inquiry could be very dangerous to those who are concerned. They will have to take steps, however dangerous, to prevent it from happening.
Now, that's going to be rather difficult, don't you think, here in this hotel?
I don't know what you mean. I'm merely placing you under arrest for conspiring with persons unknown to attack my garrison and release the prisoners held there. Please come with me. If in the attempt you try to escape, that will be another matter. After you, Mr. Hadley.
Ah, you go out now, eh?
Seems I've no alternative. I was beginning to worry about you, Mr. Pembrey.
But I left just as soon as I got your telephone call. I say, I was right about the flies, wasn't I? Big as budgerigars. Well, I gather there have been developments up here.
Yes, yes, there have indeed. But before I forget, I wonder if you'd give this letter to the British ambassador in Athens, just in case I don't see him.
Of course, with pleasure. But what's been happening?
Well, the Major here has just come up with some new evidence, which completely clears Miss Jackson and her friends. I'm right, aren't I, Major?
Yes, of course.
Of course, you don't know each other, do you? Mr. Pembrey, this is Major Stylianos and Milos Philandrakis. He is our consul in Salonika.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
I did try to get in to see you before. If you hadn't been so busy, I'm sure we could have settled the whole matter then.
Yes, well, why don't you go down to the headquarters with the Major and settle it all there while I do my packing? Then we can all travel back to Salonika together.
Oh, a splendid idea. After you.
You will take care of Mr. Pembrey, won't you? I should hate anything to happen to him.
Happen to me? Well, what could happen to me?
Nothing, Mr. Pembrey. Mr. Hadley is making a bad joke. Here we go.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Philandrakis. I wonder if you'd get my bill. I am leaving today.
That's fine. You have happy stay.
Oh, yes, yes. Nice room, lots of view.
That's right, yes. That's right.
Mr. Hadley. Mm-hmm. The letter that... That letter you give to the consul.
I'll get it back in Athens. Nobody will see it.
Thank you.
You know, in a funny sort of a way, I almost wish you brought it off.
Well, some you win, some you lose. This one we have lost. But in the end, we will win, Mr. Hadley. We must.
Do you think one of those islands down there might be Atharkis?
No. Much further north by now.
Oh. Another few hours and we might have been...
No. That was just a threat.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. Quite sure.
James, how did you fix it?
By knowing just a little bit more about Stylianos than he thought I did. Now, would you like us...
What is it?
It's a telegram. Oh, of course. Came to the hotel and all the fuss, I've forgotten to open it.
What's the matter?
It's from Alistair Morley. He's doing a business deal for me in New York. It just hasn't come off.
It's because of me, isn't it? Because you weren't there to handle it.
No, not necessarily. It's just a normal business risk.
Yes, but if you've been able to go to New York instead of...
Now, just you drink your champagne and shut up, love, will you? And will you remember this?
What?
Don't ever do that to me again.